This camera you see here can be used as a wired or cabled camera, or you can use it as a wireless standalone camera. I'll show you how you can set it up in either ways in this video. We'll first see how to set it up as a wired or cabled camera. And so we'll be using this POA switch to both provide power to the camera and also receive the camera videos for onward transfer into an NVR or to a router, depending on how you want to receive your videos. For this demonstration, I would like to receive the camera videos on my laptop. So I will use a router which will sit between the laptop and the network switch. Here are the camera's terminals. We'll be using this PoE splitter since the camera is a non-PoE camera. So I'll start by connecting the PoE splitter to the camera. This end of the splitter is where I'll plug a network cable and plug into the PoE switch. So I'll plug my network cable here. And this other end will go into the PoE switch. Any of the PoE ports can be used. This is the setup so far. If I were using an NVR, I would have connected the uplink port of the network switch into the NVR. But in my case, I'll connect the uplink port of the network switch to the router. So I'll plug this cable into the network switch and connect to any LAN port on the router. I'll also use this network cable to connect the laptop to the router. So I'll plug the network cable into the computer and plug this other end into the router. What we've done so far means that the camera and the laptop are on the same network, since the camera is connected to the network switch and the network switch is also connected to the same router as the laptop or the computer. And by that, we should be able to view the camera on the laptop using a VMS. Let's now see what to do on the computer. We need a VMS to be able to view the camera on the computer. I have already installed the VMS on my computer. If you are using JoeVision camera, you can visit joevisionsecurity.com to download a VMS. Other than that, you will need the VMS of your camera brand. That is if you are not using JoeVision cameras. So I will launch the VMS software now. I will enter my password I created on this software and then log in. We'll open device management. The software has seen the camera as listed here. So we'll double click at it. We need to enter the camera's password, which you can find in the camera's manual. I'll click OK. You can see the camera successfully added here. We can now go back to the home page of the software from the top here. We'll come down to video preview and open it up. At the left pane here, you can see a device that is listed here. We'll double click it to load it up to the live preview. Let's now see how it can be used as a wireless standalone camera. We still require a router, but this time round we'll be using its Wi-Fi, not through a cable connection. When using this camera as a standalone camera, the only connection that is required is just a 12 volts DC power to the camera. So we will disconnect all the earlier connections we made. So we'll use this 12 volts DC adapter to power up the camera now. So we'll plug it into the DC power terminal of the camera and plug this other end into the power socket. This is all the connection we need when we want to use this camera as a wireless standalone camera. So I can just switch on the DC power adapter. Since we are using the camera as a standalone camera, would be viewing its output on a smartphone. The camera uses an app called the cctv International app. You can get it from Play Store or App Store for free. So I'll open mine, which I have already installed on my phone. This is how the homepage of the app looks like. To add your camera, you will just have to tap the top here, and it presents you this opportunity to scan your camera's QR code. So I'll scan the QR code on my camera. This refers to an audio prompt that you will hear when you power on the camera, which indicates that the access point of the camera is ready. So I'll tap on this. We are now required to switch to the access point of the camera, which will appear in this format IPC-T with the rest of the figures. So I'll tap on switch Wi-Fi. You can see the camera's access point here, so we'll choose it. Connect only this time. We are now connected to the access point of the camera. So we'll go back into the app. This is where you are required to select your Wi-Fi or your wireless internet into the camera, which would enable you to do remote viewing of your camera. So we'll tap here. This is my Wi-Fi. I will select it. After you enter your password, you can just select next. The Wi-Fi is now being configured into the camera. The camera has been added successfully. You can tap here to view the live camera. You will have to change the default password on the camera. So we can edit now. We'll choose a password and save. So we have the live video now. Your comments and questions about this video are most welcome, but please don't forget to subscribe to the channel and also give this video a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video.